take a second look. Central Crossing, and welcome to Friday. We only have 15 more tardies to rack up before we are out for the summer. Please, Central, make sure that your mask is over your mouth and your nose. Speaking of, big news. Ohio says that by June 2nd, we can get rid of the mask mandate, but I'm guessing we will still be wearing them at school for those last few days. Well, why don't we head on down to Nursing with Eli to talk about it.
Good morning, Central. Welcome to a new corner, Nursing with Eli. So as Sophia said, we don't have to wear masks. I'll get to that in a second because we have even bigger news. Fully vaccinated people don't have to wear their masks outside and get this, inside too. To be fully vaccinated, you have to get both shots and wait 2 weeks after the second one. Now, back to wearing masks. Because more people are getting vaccinated, also, almost 50% of people in Ohio have gotten their first shot. Cases are going down, which shows effectability in the vaccine with stopping the spread of pathogens. I'm excited for no more masks, but we have to keep them on until June 2nd so that the pathogens don't start spreading rapidly again. But at the same time, I don't want people to see the bottom half of my face in public. Well, that is all with Nursing with Eli. Back to you, Sophia.
Wow, that's cool. Do you know what else is cool? The weather. I personally believe that Mother Nature needs to wake up and realize that it's literally May. What can you tell us about this weather with John?
Hey guys, I'm John, and the weather is going to be nice yet again for this morning. It'll be 42 for our low with some sun. For our afternoon, it'll be 66 for our high with some clouds in the sky, which is going to suck, but we'll have low winds. So you guys' hair will be fine. For Saturday, the low will be 49 and the high will be 79, with it being mostly cloudy. For Sunday, it'll be 51 for the low and our high will be 69 for that day. And it'll be cloudy yet again. Other than that, I hope you guys have a good weekend, and on to you, Seth.
Thanks, John. Now on to sports with me and Hunter.
Tonight, we have boys varsity baseball away against Groveport Madison, and the boys freshmen and JV are playing at home, also against Groveport Madison. And then tomorrow, we have boys freshmen and JV baseball away against Watkins Memorial in a doubleheader. And then we have the boys and girls track team going away at Lancaster High School against Lancaster, Newark Senior, Reynoldsburg, and Pick Central. So good luck to all you Comet athletes. You'll crush it out there.
Next, we have some congratulations to send out. Yesterday, we had 5 of our football players sign with colleges. Take a look. Congratulations to each of you. Your Comet family is proud of your accomplishments on and off the field, and we wish you the best of luck next year. And then I have some result news. First up is baseball news. If you know a varsity baseball player in class, please congratulate them on their season they are having so far. They are 15-9 and 10-4 in the OCC. Wish them the best of luck in their tournament game next Wednesday. Go Comets.
Wow, baseball, that's awesome. Way to go. Well, now I have some track news. Last night, the track team competed in the semifinals of the OCC.
I got this feeling inside my bones. It goes electric, wavy when I turn it on. Off from my city, off from my home. We're flying up, no ceiling when we in our zone. I got that sun.
sunshine in my pocket. Got that good soul in my feet. I feel that hot blood in my body when it drops. Ooh, I can't take my eyes off of it. Moving so phenomenally. Come on, like the way we rock it. So don't stop. And under the lights when everything goes, nowhere to hide when I'm getting you close. When we move, well, you already know. So just imagine.
Good job, track, and good luck tomorrow at the finals in Lancaster.
Well, that's all from us in the sports world. Good luck to all you Comet athletes. Now, let's dive into some building news. On to you, Talasia and Aaliyah. What do you girls got for us?
Well, thanks, Hunter and Seth. The dynamic duo has some important news. One more time, congratulations, AP students. There's one more test this week, AP Bio. Good luck to those of you testing today. I wanted to let you know that the AP staff students are taking their AP exam on Monday, 5/17 at noon. They are actually the last AP exam. Shout out to you guys. We're rooting for you.
Next is for you graduating seniors. You will lose access to your Google Classroom on June 30th. If you would like to export your data and files to a personal Google account, you can use Google Takeout to do that. Check your Google Cohort Classroom for instructions.
Now I have some library news. Seniors, you must have your library books returned by the end of today. And then underclassmen, make sure all your library materials are returned by the last week of school.
I now have an opportunity. Common Academy, the freshman orientation that is held a few days before school, is currently taking applications. Anyone who is currently in 9th to 11th grade are eligible. If you are interested in being a TA for the incoming freshman, pick up an application from your English teacher or visit Ms. Fuller in room 264 or Ms. Hoffner in room 234. So, let's go to Laban Ogun. What? Laban Ogun? What is that?
Your most fashionable trusted news source is here. Let's start off with some clubs. Today, GSA will meet in room 281 directly after school. This is a great club to get involved with, especially if one of your goals is to create equality in our world. It would be really great for you to come and meet the school group of people.
And then, anyone interested in becoming a Comet Crisis captain for next year should attend the meeting next Wednesday, May 19th at 7:30 a.m. in room 264. See Ms. Fuller with questions.
Let's see what we got from stuff out of the building.
Last night, a lottery ticket winner won $26 million. He then proceeded to accidentally throw his ticket in the washer with his clothes and ruin the ticket, making it unusable and losing a chance at $26 million. This is the biggest rip in 2021's history.
Also, before we go, we would like to wish the band on their concert tonight great luck. Break a leg.
And we hope the NJROTC has a great award ceremony tonight.
Well, that's all for our most trusted news source. CCHS News, signing out.